Hello, in this lesson, we are going to filter the gallery of contacts based on what the user selects in the drop-down menu. Let's click in the gallery, and we can see here that we already have a formula that does the search based on the text input, as we did in previous classes. Now, we are going to do using the drop-down menu. In order to better understand, I'm going to comment this, and we are going to implement from scratch. Later, in a future class, we are going to combine both. In order to comment, I'm going to add two slashes in the beginning of the line, and this line is not going to be considered anymore in the formula. Let me put again the TB contact to have the list of contacts that comes from the Excel file as we already connected before. And now we have back the full list of contacts because we just commented out the search function. Let's implement the filter based on what's selected in the dropdown. In order to do this, we need to put the formula in the items properties of the gallery. And in order to do the filter, we have a function that's called, guess what? Filter. So we type here filter, open the parentheses, and then we need to provide the source. That's the table that will be filtered. In this case, the source is the table called TB contacts. Okay, then we have a second parameter. That's the logical tests. If I put a comma here, I'll need to type the logical tests. That's the tests that will evaluate for each row of the table. So whatever I put here, it will go through all the rows of this table and check if the condition is true or false. If it's true, it will bring to Power Apps to display in the gallery. If it's false, it will ignore that item. Okay, as it says here, a logical test to evaluate to each row. Only the rows that pass this test will be included in the result of the filter. And what's the test? The test is if the department is the same department as is selected in the drop-down menu. So, in order to convert this to an expression, we need to tell Power Apps that we want to check for the department column. That's in this case, it's called department. So department needs to be equal the selected value in the drop-down menu. So we have DRP, department, that's the name of our input. And then we have dot, that will give us a couple of properties here. And the one we want is the selected. So selected, and then dot department name. That will bring the department name of the selected item in the department dropdown. So we get the dropdown, we get the selected item, and then inside this item we have the department name. If I close the parentheses, the filter will already work. It will check for the TB contacts and check if the department is the same as the department that's selected in the drop-down menu. I can already see here that we see sales, only the sales people, but let's play the app and change the department here. So we have, for example, marketing. If I select marketing, only people from marketing will appear in here. If I select IT, only people from IT, and so on. What if I want to unselect just to leave blank and bring all the contacts? We need to improve this formula and play with one property of the dropdown. And we are going to see this in the next class. I see you there. If this video was useful to you and you want to keep learning Power Apps, don't forget to subscribe and activate the notification so you will know when new videos arrive. I will also add a suggested video here so you can keep learning. See you in the next video. Bye bye.